looking forward to this one. Yeah. Man. Well. So how you been, man?
Very good.
Yeah?
Very good.
Feels like I haven't seen you for like, what is it? Maybe like 6 months, you reckon? Yeah, there's some of us that saw you, right?
Yeah, more than 6 months. More than 6 months.
Yeah? Wow.
So, you've been busy.
Yeah, man. Is there any chefs you've been following around town that you sort of really are sort of eyeing their next move or wondering what they can be up to now?
Looking at what chefs do now doesn't really help me and help the business.
Yeah.
You know? Izu.
Yeah.
Izu's a machine now.
Yeah, definitely.
I admire these people, no? Like,
yeah.
You make time to do all this.
From what I can see from the outside in, it's clear that your mind is on your ingredients, it's on your dish. It seems to me and the rest of the outside world is that's what's making you succeed, and that is what this whole hype is about. It's not just hype, it's dedication to your craft. And you've done it so well.
I always put heart and my soul into what I really love.
So when was the first time you realized it started working and people are just like coming every Wednesday, they knew it was Wednesday, the shipment's coming. When did you really know that you're going to keep doing this?
It was really unintentional. The initial plan for Trivials was sliders and sushi. They were sitting here at a bar, I was doing fry order, some stuff coming. And I said, sit down, and then I start feeding them nigiri. I didn't know how to make nigiris back then. I was just playing, I was just testing out, just making them guinea pigs, you know,
try. Yeah.
And then that worked out really well, and then they told a friend, and then brought another friend. The friend brought another friend. All of a sudden, one call from, oh, we need a booking of 4 counter, chef's table. We're calling from London.
Wow. Oh,
said, okay, now no joke.
Wow,
people were like asking, is the chef there? Is chef doing the menu and all that?
So do you think that like, the fact that you're in the kitchen every night, or at least on the Wednesday, you're cooking in there with your team.
Yeah.
You're preparing these ingredients in front of everybody. You're doing it twice a week, right? Is that what you
twice
said?
A week, yeah.
Twice a week. Okay. So, do you think that's where the real hype has sort of come from, with people just knowing that you're in the kitchen, and that's a rare experience these days in Dubai, where the owner of the restaurant is also in the kitchen.
Yeah.
Do you think that's one of the things that has definitely sort of helped, you know, put you in the spotlight so much?
This helped where, you know, people in the industry, the extreme foodies.
Yeah.
If I want to show off, this is where I show off.
Yeah.
This is the main stage.
Yeah.
This is where, you know, you get that humble service.
Yeah.
The value for money kind of food.
Yeah.
No food, quick, light, you know. Everything's fresh. Everything's pretty much very us.
Yeah.
That position we are,
yeah.
The identity we are.
Yeah.
Trivials would never be a fine dining.
Yeah.
This is my stamp. It'll never be fine dining.
Yeah.
What I can provide is the little bits and pieces of how my training is. You know?
Yeah.
Trivials has always been that casual concept. Humble, casual, warm. You know, you feel like, oh, I'm coming back to my favorite restaurant. Come in, there's this place, sit. Can I make a reservation? No.
Yeah.
Why? Because we are casual.
Yeah.
If you find 2 seats, you sit. If the table's for 4, you're 5, you sit 5, you can sit 5.
Yeah.
No, there's no rule. The only rule is eat and pay and go.
Yeah.
That's the only rule.
So what do you think is like the future of Dubai dining?
Over here is something very different. 80% of mixed people from everywhere, right? And probably 50% are laborers who don't even expect them to come in.
Yeah.
You know? They don't even know, they don't even care about it. So you have multicultures who has different expectations, different eating style, different eating culture, different spending power. So how do you be a restaurant who tries to adapt and cater to all these people? Impossible.
Yeah.
Impossible, I'm telling you, impossible. I thought I could try to do that. Impossible.
I'm just really excited to get into the kitchen tonight.
Yeah.
To see what you guys are actually doing there.
Come on, let's
that would be amazing.
Look, one.
This guy.
Good to
see you, buddy.
His name is Anthony.
Okay.
From Philippines.
Yeah.
When we first opened, he came and asked me for a job for 3 times.
Really?
I interviewed him.
Yeah.
I kicked him out. Interviewed second time. Kicked him out again. He came again and then he said he decided to become a chef. Now he's making 7,000 sushi for 3 days.
Yes! That's a cool story. Nice.
So this is Dewey.
Okay.
Dewey.
Hi, man.
Good. Dewey worked for me in Django. So he's a full-fledged bartender.
Nice.
He goes on like making, you know, all this what? Mixology, blah, blah, blah.
Kind of I make like the one which is like the any technique, the drinks and things. Yeah.
So now, Trifuel is no alcohol.
Really?
Zero.
Yeah, of course, yeah.
So I said to him, the challenge is you develop something that you've never been comfortable before.
Yeah.
So now we have produced like doing fermentation of drinks.
Wow.
Our maceration and all that. Yeah, juices. Yeah. Now he's doing.
Awesome. Cool, man.
Big challenge, but.
Great job. Very cool. Well done. Love to meet you.
Thank you.
Hi, guys. How are you?
So the kitchen is very simple. 4 stove, one hot plate, 2 fryer, that's it.
Yeah.
Very tight. Very compact.
Amazing.
This is Roland.
Hey, buddy. How are you, man? Good to see you. Nice to meet you.
So, besides my 2 sous chefs, right, Roland was the first outside person who came and worked for us.
Right.
So he came through what? Your brother, cousin or something? Was cleaner in one of the restaurants. So he's from Cameroon, so he came, lost, you know? You know what to do, came, put on the uniform, put on the apron, start washing. And then the week after this guy came, his motion. So motion's from Nigeria. So pretty much both of them are the oldest.
Okay.
The oldest. So he came, also 2 dishwashers in. So we had my chefs and myself also.
Awesome.
Now they're pretty much in charge of the main kitchen. They're expediting, they're doing production and all that. But these guys came for nothing. He couldn't even cut knife. He couldn't cut onions.
So now they're doing prep and they're doing everything, right?
These are my pillars.
Wow. Nice, guys. Good
with,
work,
with
huh?
Zero experience.
Zero.
You know, they got a lot of shit from you. I was not like, oh, let's go. No, we were like breaking them.
Wow.
But they survived this through this phase. You know, being in the kitchen is not about, well, have passion.
Yeah.
Bullshit passion, what passion? If you can't endure, you can't take this, then you will never reach the passion. Passion is after this obstacle.
So where is next for them now?
So now we're growing, you know. Given them pass, they move up the ranks.
Nice.
You know, making them be able to grow, you know?
Yeah.
Making our life better, their life better. You know?
Yeah.
That's all my dream was.
Right.
No, now we have all these people now contributing to the restaurant.
Amazing.
We started out with 8 plus service, now we're 20 over.
Yeah. So how many covers you do out of here for night now? Wow.
300 with 4 stove.
Wow. So, one big flat grill, a little 4 burner, two double deep fryers.
Yeah.
That's
it.
We
400 covers. How many plates do you can get?
400 plates. Covers? What? Times 2-3 maybe? So, yeah.
1,000.
Maybe 1,000? Maybe?
1,000 plates.
Right.
Plus glasses.
Yeah.
Plus.
Yeah.
Only this.
Wow. That's pumping.
This,
how many times have you changed this one now?
This is since day one.
Wow. The maintenance must be good. Or is this guy's just pushing it
through?
Yeah, it's so cool. It's small. I knew it was small, but I didn't know how small.
Small walking chiller.
Nice.
So we have guys who prep, we have guys who do service.
Hi, buddy. How are you? Well, it looks very organized. It's amazing. Well done, guys. Keeping a great kitchen here. Cool. Great to see.
So ready to eat?
Yeah, man. Let's do it.